Well guys, good news. It's gonna be kind of a different video. I'm not gonna really edit much. So, I finished kind of welding in the mounts. So I'm just gonna take you along for the ride and we'll put the engine in. I should be able to hang the engine on its own weight now. Leave a comment if you're excited. Tell me how excited you are. On a scale from this much to this much. Unless something really bad happens. So, let's do that. I know it's been a few days. I haven't really done much. Just kind of working and, you know, being a piece of shit. Doing job stuff. So got those mounts welded up. Try to slap this piece of shit in there. Pump this 100 fucking times. So this is normally what you don't see. They try to edit all this stuff out. So in the process of welding the mounts in, I had this engine in and out of there probably 10, 12 times. It's pretty exciting doing this. Got a lot of like different test fitting steps. You think you're close and then you push it in a little bit. And then you're close, but you're not quite there. Then you gotta pull the whole fucking thing out again. In and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. Just to tell a bunch of dudes on YouTube that I threw a bunch of metal inside of a bigger chunk of metal. My hoist is kind of a piece of shit. Because I dropped an engine on it once. Being stupid. Engine actually dropped and flipped over and smashed the freaking leg, broke the wheel off. That was exciting. Put a hole in the ceiling. Oops. Yeah, I'll show you the hole in the ceiling. So basically, it happened a long time ago. The chain and the mounting point broke. Engine flipped upside down. Tail shaft of the transmission went into the ground. And chain broke. Went up and fucking put a little hole in the ceiling. So that hole there is from this engine hoist actually hitting the ceiling when the fucking chain broke. So there's a lot of tension on there. There's a lot of tension on there and it just snapped up and put a hole in the ceiling. Then take the whole engine back apart again and then check everything and make sure everything was good. Luckily the engine was still okay. It fucked up my hoist and my ceiling. too many times now, so I'm just getting sick of it. Yeah, these mounts, engine mounts, are actually pretty close together. There's some little barbs and like spots that stick out of the block. You gotta be really careful on lowering it down, which I'm not really good at. Stuck. It's really not too bad as far as actually getting it in. Don't take that long. Doesn't take long to get it in. It just matters what you do when you have it in there, right? Kind of lined up now. I think it's pretty close lined up. I'll go underneath and throw the bolts in. I'm under here now. Well, if there's anything you can see. Basically putting these bolts in. I got them in finger tight. I spared you all that. All it was a bunch of me grunting and getting shit in my eyes. I'm just gonna go through and throw a couple of these bolts in. Then I'll get the other one in on this side in from the top. Go through and battery's dying. I'm just going to go through and tighten these back up by hand. And now, see if I can relieve the weight. A day in the life. So exciting. Alright, so, just putting in these last bolts now. Still got tension on the hoist. Luckily. I'm gonna drop this piece of shit too. Okay. If you're wondering why I'm using a wrench instead of a socket, because I can't seem to find any of my short 15 millimeter sockets right now. Because I'm awesome. So we'll do it the old-fashioned way. Alright, so that's tight. It should still be tight. The not so glamorous part, guys. The part you don't see. All the work. Annoying bullshit. Okay. So let's see. I'll let the weight off. Tilt back a little bit. And here we have it. It's official. The engine is now in the truck on its own. That's pretty exciting. I know I'm excited. Are you excited? Tell me how much excited you are. Okay, so it's in, it's hanging on its own weight. I do probably want to lift it up a little bit again just because the mounting point isn't completely straight and I just don't want all that extra tension on the mounts for now. So I'm gonna keep it in the truck, but I'll lift it up just a little bit just to keep the weight off the mounts, and then tomorrow I'm going to go in and then start putting the transmission in. So I might have made a mistake by doing it this way, because I think there's like a pinch weld inside the transmission tunnel that I wanted to beat out. I might be able to get it from the bottom, and I might not even need to. So I guess we'll see where it's at. If it's really that bad, I'll just pull the engine back out tomorrow, because it doesn't take that long. So, all right. Cool, thanks for watching. Thanks for helping me get through this grueling task. It's really not that bad. It's done like 10 times already, so. Alrighty. Bitches. Bitches and bitches. See how much the truck comes up. Alright. Cool. I'm excited. More work tomorrow.